Welcome to the Cinema Gold Show. I'm your host, Larry Weiss. Today we're diving into our classic rewind series. But for the month of October, we're taking a look at some of the, better known horror movies, comedies, thrillers, a little bit of both. Today we're starting with Freaky. First, we'd like to thank our sponsor, Pondex, for sponsoring this episode. You can visit Pondex.com, use promo code Larry21 for 10% off. And also, our new sponsor is Audible. Check out audibletrial.com/Larry21 for a free 30-day trial and free audiobook of your choice. So without further ado, let's take a dive into Freaky. Basic switch, killer new look. It's hard to believe that it's taken us this long to get a body swap slasher movie. Similar to what filmmaker Christopher Landon and producer Jason Blum did with their ghoulish reworking of Groundhog Day, with the 1-2 punch of Happy Death Day and Happy Death Day to You, they're back with the insanely entertaining Freaky, a mashup of the Freaky Friday films and Friday the 13th series. This is the freshest concept around. We've seen this story multiple times. Freaky is elevated by a sharp script, some decent gore, and a couple of killer performances from Vince Vaughn, who plays a demented serial killer, and Catherine Newton as the introverted high schooler that winds up in his body.
I want my body back.
Come and get it.
The movie opens on Wednesday the 11th in classic horror movie fashion, where a group of teenagers are brutally murdered in a lavish manner by a killer known as the Blissfield Butcher, played by Vince Vaughn, who offs the use before stealing an ancient dagger known as Lindola. The next day, we meet Millie Kessler, a timid high school teen who's recently lost her father and is being bullied and picked on at school. At night, she finds herself alone in the school parking lot after attending a homecoming football game, where she performed as the school mascot, the Blissfield Beaver. Of course, she's attacked by the butcher, who impales Millie with the dagger before fleeing the scene. Alas, the following morning, Friday the 13th, of course, Millie wakes up inside the body of her killer, who's now in her petite teenage skin, taking control of her life, which she shares with her widowed alcoholic mother, Coral, and her big sister, police officer, Charlene. Now, with Millie inside the demented madman, she must stay out of sight as the town searches for the Blissfield Butcher. All the while, Millie must try to convince her friends, the flamboyant Josh and outspoken Nyla, and she's now a middle-aged man, with Millie eventually learning that unless she stabs the butcher with the dagger before midnight, the body switch will be irreversible. Written by Landon and Michael Kennedy, Freaky instantly draws viewers in with a tense, blood-soaked opener that's reminiscent of the Friday the 13th and Halloween series. It rarely lets up from there. Furthermore, Freaky is hoisted further by the work of cinematographer Laurie Rose from Free Fire, and production designer, Hillary and Dujar of Scare Package, who create a bright, eerie backdrop for the ensuing madness. While the history of the butcher and the magical dagger are a little undercooked, there's a real humanity to Newton's Millie, who's a more complex character and is given a depth that's akin to that of Roth's heroine from Happy Death Day films. With that said, movie makers have a great time with the whole body swapping concept, chiefly when it comes to watching two very different people awkwardly slip into their new skins. Millie is a shy teen who struggles to connect with her hard drinking mother and longs for her dream boy, Booker Strode, who barely seems to notice her. The butcher, however, is the complete opposite of Millie. He's a strong, intimidating muster who's used to forcefully getting his way. There's quite a big divide when it comes to these two characters, but the performers do a tremendous job in making the switch work. Vince Vaughn uses his large physique early on to communicate menace, and then turns to his old school comic chops when he's playing Millie, eliciting a ton of laughs. There's a very funny bathroom scene, and another when he's performing a silly high school cheer to prove that he's in fact Millie. Whether he's freaking out with his BFFs or connecting with Crush Booker, Vaughn is totally believable as Millie and seems to be having a hell of a time. Similarly, Catherine Newton is excellent as both Millie and the Butcher, effortlessly transforming from a withdrawn teen to an ice cold killer, the Butcher giving Millie a new sense of style, ultimately exposing her untapped potential. Given that Landon's Happy Death Day films were rated PG-13, he seems to be relishing Freaky's R rating here, going to town with the blood splattered kills, Newton turning heads and oozing empowerment, taking out those who've been giving her a hard time at school, such as mean girl Ryler and her unsympathetic woodshop teacher, Mr. Bernardi, who gets the best thing in the film. Elsewhere, Misha Usherich and Celeste O'Connor give great support as Millie's pals Josh and Nyla, the pair getting caught up in the folly and delivering a handful of laughs, chiefly the overtly gay Josh, who at one point is tasked with keeping an eye on the butcher who's been tied to a chair at Josh's home. Telly actress Katie Fennerin is also memorable as Millie's grieving mom, Cora, who shares a sweet moment with Vaughn in a thrift store change room, unaware that she's actually talking to her daughter. Really, though, kudos to the filmmakers for putting together such a progressive cast without making too much of a fuss about it. All said, Freaky is a breezy 102 minutes of wicked fun and another great collaboration by Landon and Blumhouse. Give it a stab, you won't be disappointed. Vaughn and Newton deliver in spades, while filmmaker Landon dishes out exactly what's promised on the tin. Who knows, this might be the start of another Freaky franchise for Landon. And so I'd give this a movie about maybe somewhere between 3.5 and 4, closer to the 4. So probably I'll go with maybe 3.8. So if you've seen this movie, let us know what your thoughts are in the comment section below. Did you like it? What did you think about Vince Vaughn's performance? Did you care for it? Did you even watch it? Let us know your thoughts. As always, you can find us on Twitter at Cinema Gold Show, on Instagram at The Cinema Gold Show, and on Facebook right over there. And now, onto our pod deck segment, Film Night. Today's question is, do you have a ton of movies to watch in your Netflix queue? What are some of them? That is actually a good question that I have to pull up to even look at, because I know I have a bunch, I just haven't watched yet. Let's see. Zodiac, Training Day, The Game, The Interpreter, let's see, Malcolm X, Olympus Has Fallen, Point Blank, Woman in the Window, Triple Frontier, and surprisingly, The Irishman, which I still haven't watched yet. Murder Mystery, which I've watched before, but plan on watching it again. Yeah, it's most of them. There's a bunch of other ones, but they're all series. So we want to know what you have in your Netflix queue. What do you have to watch? We haven't started yet. Let us know in the comment section below. And as always, you can join our Patreon by going to patreon.com/cinemagold. And if you want to support the show, you can buy us a coffee at buymeacoffee.com/cinemagold. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.